Hi guys, Penny Rose Journals, how you doing? Using stuff up again today. These papers are some of the ones that I made digitals for my Etsy. And of course, you know, in that process, you have to print a lot of them out to see what they're looking like. So, yeah, I had a stack of them on my desk and I've had them for a long time. So yeah, you know how it is. You got some on your desk, you just want to get rid of them eventually. These cards that I'm sticking them to were also floating around my desk after cleaning up some stuff the other day. I found them again, and they are cards from fabric samples. So yeah. Thing is, they were all just sort of sitting there together. I thought, well, we'll put them together and see what we can come up with. So this was kind of a project that I went, I don't know what I'm doing, but I'm just gonna start doing. So I stuck them down on one side and now I'm just gluing them around the edges and onto the other side, and then I will go from there and decide what it is that I plan to do. Well, as fun as it probably was watching me stick all those down, I cut a lot of that out. I'm sure you don't mind too much. I've covered up the gap in the back there with another piece of that paper, and I have these covered cards. Yeah, a lot brighter and more cheerful than the usual grungy stuff I do. And I thought, you know what, let's just go with it. So, as you can see down there on the right hand side, I picked some bright and cheerful fabric to go along with them, and let's do something really outlandishly bright. Although these pictures are very colourful, they're all these papers are very colourful, they're still quite distressed looking, so I'm okay with that. But yeah, this fabric's amazing. I love it. So, yeah, we're going to make something nice and bright and cheerful. And I've decided to go for a little folio kind of business. So, yeah, I'm going to use these pieces of fabric as hinges to join the cards together. And then we will go about organizing some pockets and things. So I'll speed this up and you can see how I put them together, and then we will go from there. that's our basic construction done. I found these envelopes which fit almost perfectly in here. I'm just going to cover them with a bit more of this paper and make them match everything else for bright and cheerfulness.
Thank you.
okay, let's glue some of these little envelopes in. They fit just perfectly across here, so we'll glue one in the front and one in the back, and we'll worry about the other two shortly. Decided to use sides of cereal box here. Just going to cut it into smaller pieces and cover it with some more of that paper, and we'll make some little pockets out of it. Right, here are the little pockets that I've made out of the cereal box, and we'll get around to sticking those in. going to sew a simple signature in here, simple three-hole pamphlet stitch. Don't bother to make a hole or any holes in the spine. It's just a couple of pieces of fabric that I had to push a needle through, so yeah, I'll just punch some holes through the signature and just wing it. Okay, here we have her. She's all done. She could probably use a little bit more decorating here and there maybe, but for now I'm happy with her. She's bright, she's cheerful, and she's full of bright and cheerful little things as well. There's a lot of little pockets and tuck spaces for bits and pieces. hide away little journaling notes, whatever you want to do there. And she's also got a signature. So there's somewhere to actually journal or take notes or whatever it is you want to do. She'd make a cute little ephemera holder to take on holidays. All in all, I'm very pleased with her. I just love the look of her. She's just happy. All right, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this, and I hope you give one a go yourselves. And I'll see you again next time. Enjoy. Bye.